Minification, a video we've created because we get a ton of questions about it. Questions like, is minification a real word? It all starts with code. This is not code. You can tell because it's just lines. If it was real code, we could minify it to reduce its size. Now, if you're using Webflow hosting, we're already using gzip to reduce site file sizes. So in many cases, you can see up to a 70% reduction, and that's without minifying. What minification does, and this goes all the way back to programming languages like JavaScript, and also what Wikipedia says, may also be used as a kind of obfuscation, though the term obfuscation... It was tough to concentrate on etymology, because every time we typed out minification, it autocorrected to magnification. But why would we want to minify our HTML, CSS, and JavaScript? Simple. It means fewer bytes being downloaded when someone loads up the page. That's a big deal. Site performance doesn't just affect website visitor happiness, or WVH for short. Performance is also a key indicator to ranking algorithms, like those used by search engines. So, how do we do this in a Webflow project? Before publishing or exporting your project, head on over to Project Settings. When you get there, go over to the Hosting tab. All the way at the bottom, you'll see some options for minifications. And if you'd like, you can minify your HTML, your CSS, and your JavaScript. Save changes, then publish or export your project. And that's minification of code inside of Webflow.